Hello and welcome to Cimbrer Bushcraft. Today you can see I'm in my camp again, and I have something special to show you. This is how my shelter looked when I came here. Opened the tarp. You can see some firewood that I cut down last time I was here and put it into my shelter so it could be kept dry there. And I also have bought some sheep skins. You can see here. Very warm and long-haired sheepskins. I love them, and they are very suitable in my Viking camp here. So I'm grateful for that. And beside that, you can see my flag is up, Raven banner. So officially, the Cimbrer camp is open. Yeah. But welcome, and I hope you would like this little video, and I hope you stay on. Yeah. And besides showing you my new upgrade here in Cimbrer camp and telling you about this product, I'm going to cut some firewood because next week my good old friend Johnny, if everything goes after plan, will come here and we'll make an overnighter. It's been a cold day today, -3 degrees Celsius, and the winter is finally arrived in Denmark, and I think it will continue with that in the next couple of weeks. So it's going to be a cold overnighter here, but luckily I have my worktop stove. So I'm very grateful for that, and I'm actually going to make a fire inside my shelter today with my little skillet. I'll show you in a minute what it is, and because I won't go outside, it's very cold and windy, so in here it's warm and there's no wind, and I'll make my little fire here and preparing a little meal. And it's an American inspired meal with a Danish twist. So yeah, I hope you enjoy that too. And those of you who have followed me for a while know that some months ago there was a thief or thieves in here and stole some of my stuff, including my two reindeer skin that I have out here. I didn't bring them home every time because they there was a lot of hair that was coming out of the fur, so I didn't want to drive it, have it in my car. So now I've got these sheepskins, and the hairs is staying on, so I can transport them every time I'm out here. I won't let them be out here in my camp. And beside the furs or the skin, they took a lot of stuff out here. And actually, I haven't told you that, but just before Christmas, they actually came back and stole a lot of other things, including my lanterns, my Feuhan lanterns and some other stuff. And so it actually made me a little bit sadder the second time they came here, because then I knew they would come back, and where I'm afraid that I can't stop that. So that is why I have got my new upgrade in Cimbrer camp, because that way I am certain I will find the thieves if they come back, or at least identify them, and other stuff. Yeah, it's very cool. I will talk about that a little later. But now I think I'm going to start a little fire out here to get warm and start preparing my little meal. So hang on.
Yeah, and it is this Patronmark griddle, I think it's called. You can actually use it for cooking food on, make the fire downwards and have this like a skillet, but you can also use it as I do. I put my wood on here and make my fire on top of this. So this is what I'm going to do. Light my fire and get some warm in here and start preparing my food. Yeah, and this is what I meant when I said an American-inspired meal with a Danish twist. I'm going to make hot dogs out here today, and yeah, this is bread. You probably know that, but have you seen red sausages before? I think it's a Danish tradition that we actually make them red with some color. And these sausages is called røde pølser, and if you can pronounce that, you're a true Dane, because it's a very difficult word to say, and we always tease our visitors from out abroad that they have to say røde pølser. So even the Norwegian and the Swedish can't pronounce it right. We normally cook these sausages and we have some brown ordinary that we put on the fire, but I'll make them over the fire today, no problem there, and my little bread. So, and I have got ketchup and mushroom with me. Really looking forward to tasting this little meal, hot dogs in Danish, røde pølser. Yeah. First I'm going to level this out a little bit, spread it, and because I have sand on the floor in here, I don't worry about dropping anything. That was the reason why I made this. And to grill it, I got this from BBQ. It's an awesome grill. I made it. I used it many times, and if you watch my cooking videos, you will see that I'm using this. It's very awesome little thing. It can fold up and be a big grill, and you can use it. That's a small grill. Yeah. I can put it here. Yeah. Right there. And then the bread. And the sausages. So now I just have to wait until it's finished. I'm actually beginning to get hungry. Better. Yeah. Yeah, now I think it's finished, yeah, and I'll put some more firewood on so that I can have a fire in here again, not only coals. And then
going to make me a hot dog. Some mustard. Actually, I also prefer onion, but I forgot them back home. That's okay. This is nice too. As you can see. Yeah. Danish hot dog with a rød pølse. Now time for a cup of coffee. And the salt here is removing the bitterness from the coffee, especially when you make cooking coffee as I do, it can be a little bitter, so this will make it more sweet or more smooth. Now it's starting to boil a little bit, so about 2 minutes and then I can have my coffee. Yep. Let it rest for a minute or so.
Yeah, and this is the reason why this video called an upgrade in Cimbrer Camp. I actually got myself a security camera, surveillance camera out here, and yeah, I made a video about that, and you can see it here.
And look what I've got. Yeah, it's a surveillance camera and security camera from a company called Reolink. And this is the Reolink Go PT with a solar panel. So this surveillance camera I can put up in my camp and use a SIM card as the one you use in your phones, and then I can watch my camp back home, and of course it will make an alert if someone is trespassing my little piece of forest out there. I think this company maybe have watched my video where I told that I have been there have been burglars in my camp, so well, it's a good idea that they sent me this, and I'm looking very much forward to putting this up, and so I can be a little more cool about my place. I opened it before, so this is an unboxing, but not the first time. But in here, I would like to show you, because it's really nice package it's come in, and yeah, all the items in here are top quality. Here at the top, there's this with the manual in, and I'll look at this a little bit later. And down here, yeah, I'll just take it up. Here, there's a holder, and the actual camera is down here. Yeah, and down here there's some fittings, so I can put it on the tree or something. This is screws and a cable, and down here there's actually one I can put around a tree. If I choose to put it up on a live tree, I can use these so I don't have to make any holes in the trees. So that is cool. And this camera, you just put it on here. Yeah. And then I have a security camera. This camera, I'll talk a little bit about that later, but it could actually be removed from my phone. I can make it tilt up and down and to the sides. Of course, I put a link in my video description so you can see actually what this awesome camera can. Yeah, this, and then down here, it's here. Yeah. It's an antenna, and there is this solar panel, yeah, with a cord to the camera, and of course it can also be attached to the tree, to the pole that I choose. And yeah, this camera, when I put it up, this solar panel will provide the power for this camera, so I don't need any power out there. I haven't got any power out there, so that's cool, but you can use this everywhere, and it will send you messages via a mobile network, and you can see videos. And another very cool thing is that you can actually put this camera to make an alert out in the camp if someone is trespassing you, or you can actually talk to the people you see and they can talk back to you. That's really cool. Yeah, and the antenna is going in here, and here's a slot for if you want to charge it. Of course it's a chargeable battery in here, and down here there's a slot for a SIM card and also an SD card, so I can record anything that happens out in my camp. It's very cool. And actually in here is some very nice stuff. These I can put on my shelter if I want to, so people can see that it's a security camera, and of course some manuals so I can see how it works. And then in here is actually a SIM card that you can use for this, but it's a company called Vodafone, I think it's pronounced, and we doesn't have that in Denmark, so I'm going to find another provider, another company that can give me a SIM card like this. And then I'm going, and here in Denmark you buy a SIM card and then you have a year's service, and it costs about $10 a month, and you have 2 gigabytes. It's the one that I've looked at here in Denmark. It can be different in your country, but it's cool if you have Vodafone in your country. You just have to put this in and activate the SIM card and this little nice camera. And I looked at the video, I haven't tried it yet, so well, I think it's correct, but the only thing you have to do is put your SIM card in and turn it on, and then you have an app on your phone, and it should be very easy to install and make this camera work, and I'm looking very much forward to that. When I first got this camera, I thought, well, that's a lot of reading there, but I don't think it's so difficult. I just have to put my SIM card in, and this camera will tell me that it's active, and then I'll, via my phone, my iPhone, and the app, I can set up this camera and make it work as I would like to. So very easy, I hope, and of course I'll tell you about how it's going when I'm finished with that. But nevertheless, I'm very grateful that Reolink has sent me these wonderful items, and I'm looking very much forward to begin using them. I'm still searching for a company that can sell me that SIM card, and I'm well, sometime in the next couple of days I probably have found the right one, and then I'll order one. So, but this is what you get in the package, and they are sold on Amazon, and I've put a link to that too. And here in Denmark there's actually some companies that sell these too, and that's where I got most of my information, because it's in Danish and I can understand those, and also the YouTube videos, very nice. So yeah, that was all for now. Now I'll show you, the next clip will be some days later when I have probably put this up at my camp and tell you how it is working. So hang on.
Yeah, and today I'm going out in my camp and putting up my security camera. As you can see, I have painted it in camouflage. That's because I have to hide it out there. I found a tree that I will put it up in, so I can film the camp, and this one will catch the light, the sun from the south. I'm not going to show you exactly where I put it up, because if the burglar or the thieves are watching my videos, it's too easy for them to take it down before I can even notice that they are there. So I'm hoping and praying that this will help me prevent or at least find the ones that have stolen things from my camp. Yeah, so now I'm, as I said before, going to put it up and show you how it works on the app. It's very awesome. I tested it out, and it's actually very easy to use. Yeah, and now I put the camera up and I go in here and see if it is working. Just a moment. It's connecting now. Yeah. And this one. Yeah. As you can see, I'm waving now. I have a live camera. It's awesome. It's so great. And well, it's cold today, so I will go home and tell you all about this amazing little camera and the app that you can download for this. Yeah.
Yeah, here you can see I'm out in my camp and actually recording while I'm sitting out there. It was a great experience to find out what this camera actually can. And this is the one quality, and I can actually make a better quality, a full HD quality, 1080 pixels. Isn't that something? Yeah. You can see it's very sharp. I can easily see who's in my camp. Hello, everyone. Yeah. And now I'm trying to make a picture of it. I can also take a picture. There you are. Yeah. And at night, that's awesome. You can actually see everything at night. It's night vision camera too. So if everyone comes out there during the night, I can see that too. It's so awesome. Yeah. Nice little camera. I love it.
It's actually very easy to use this app. You can get it from App Store or Google Play, I think it's called. Now I'm going in, connecting. Yeah, there you are. Then I push this one, and I get a bigger picture there. So you can see I have some options down here. I can record video from the camp. Yeah. And I can take a picture. And here I have low light, or you can see 1080. It's a better picture you get there. And if I think I'll take it, and if I do this, you can see here I can actually move the camera. So I can move the camera out in my camp, up and down and sideways, and that's very cool too. Take this one off, and here up I can, if I press this, I can hear from the camp. I can hear what's going on there. And you can't hear it now. And some other cool stuff is that press this button, I can actually talk to the people that are out in my camp. Hello, what are you doing there?
In my camp. Hello, what are you doing there?
Yeah, that's cool. And playback. So it's a really cool app, and it's actually not that difficult to install. There's some technical things you have to write, and those things, those data things you get from your mobile cell provider when you're getting this the SIM card for data. And I'm giving, it cost me about $100 a year for having this cam, and I have 2 gigabytes a month of data. That should be plenty. So you just have to download this app, and then you have to install the camera, and it tells you what you're going to do, so it's very easy to work with. Yeah. So very cool. And when I'm out in the camp, I'll just show you. I can PIR monitor, I just turn that off, and then I'm not going to be every time there's motion out in my camera, I get a notification and an email that's saying that someone or some movements are detected out in the camp. And you can see 95% battery. It's not been bright today, so my solar cell has not charged it 100%, but it's okay, this one. You can see there the quality. There's a lot of things you can do with this app. It's really awesome. And again, now I can down at my house can see that nothing is wrong in Cimbrer Camp. I'm very grateful for that. That gives me a little bit calm when I'm going out there. I don't have to worry about if anyone has been there. So all in all, a really nice camera and a nice app for it. Very easy to use. Yeah.
Yeah, isn't that a great thing to have here in my Cimbrer Camp? I'm so grateful that Reolink has offered me such a wonderful surveillance camera, and I'm very surprised about the quality and the things that I can do with it. As you saw in my video, it's awesome, and I can recommend that for others that have the same issues as I have, intruders in your camp. It runs on, as I said, mobile network, so don't need Wi-Fi out here. That's great. So thank you very much, Reolink, for sponsoring this video and my new surveillance camera. I'm very grateful for that. Now it's time for packing down my gear again and heading home. This video, and I'm looking very much forward to next week when hopefully me and Johnny will make an overnight out here. I'll make some footage for that too. I'm not sure if I'm going to make a video between these two. Maybe I do that, but then again, never knows what happens. So again, thank you for watching Cimbrer Bushcraft. I really appreciate that, and welcome to my many new subscribers here the last couple of weeks. I have some videos that were very popular, so a lot of new friends out there. I'm looking forward to meeting you in my comments section, and I hope you stay on. Hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care.